Mr. Provost, I declare the 2019-2020 academic year at Utica College to be in session.
Thank you, Dr. Rossi. Will everyone please remain standing for our national anthem, which will be sung by Utica College senior Nicole Collette.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, we're so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Thank you very much, Nicole. If everyone please be seated. I would like to extend a very warm welcome to everyone, and especially to our new students. Out of courtesy, we do ask that you please turn off or silence your cell phones. Please refrain from texting during the ceremony. It is now my great pleasure to introduce the following individuals who are seated on the stage. Utica College President, Dr. Laura Casamento. Chairman of the College Board of Trustees, Mr. Bob Brennick. Our guest speaker, Dr. Anthony Baird. Senior Vice President for Student Life and Enrollment Management, Dr. Jeffrey Gates. And Student Government Association President, Mr. Michael D'Elia. Please join me in welcoming them. My name is Todd Fonestill, and I'm the Provost and Senior Vice President for Academic Affairs here at Utica College. And I want to congratulate all the students here and welcome you to the beginning of your education at UC. Let me begin by stating I am very jealous of all of you. Please don't let the title or the fancy green robe fool you. I really wish I were all of you. I'm jealous because while I still have much to learn, your learning will occur in our classrooms, laboratories, studios. It will occur among our student groups, on the fields, the courts, and other athletic venues. It will occur through the passion and skill of these excellent faculty whom you ushered into the building this afternoon. I'm sorry, this morning. I'm already jumping ahead, guys. It won't occur from a provost dressed in a robe that looks like a Christmas tree with a name so impossible that I will never ask you to try and pronounce it. So why don't we start this again? I'm Dr. Todd. I'm a fellow student, historian, provost, and for the next few minutes with you, a Marvel comic book cinematic universe fan. We have a few of those out here? Okay, excellent. So now that I have your attention, when I was 6 years old, I began collecting superhero comic books. And to this day, I still love reading through my collection when time permits. Some 5,000 comic books, and over 40 years later, I can now reflect on the life lessons that I learned from this pop culture genre. Now, this past decade has been particularly enjoyable for me as many of my heroes, and a few villains, came to life on the big screen thanks to the Marvel Universe. Now, box office sales would suggest to me that the same is true for you as well. I would be hard-pressed to imagine that anyone here today has not seen or heard of at least one of these Marvel movies. From Iron Man to Thor and Captain America to Spider-Man, my personal favorite, Black Panther. And of course, there's the Avengers, which brought together the Hulk, Black Widow, Doctor Strange, Ant-Man, and the list goes on. Now, Now, when I was asked to prepare a few remarks for you today, I realized that many of the lessons I learned from comic books 40 years ago are applicable to your lives today as you begin at Utica College. And while you may not have read the actual comic books as I did, you likely have seen some of these films from which these lessons can be derived. So first, I want you to think about the opportunity that Utica College provides you today. In the famous movie Guardians of the Galaxy, when he was attempting to inspire his team as they prepared for battle, the Star-Lord, Peter Quill, reminds them, quote, "You think life takes more than it gives, but not today. Today it is giving us something more. It is giving us a chance." Whether your college experience is extraordinary will not be determined by what you see hands to you, but rather what you make of it. Work hard for what you believe in and aspire to, even if it may seem impossible at times. Take risks. Don't let your past define you. Trust in your professors, trust in your classmates, and you will learn that anything can happen. Second, be daring with the opportunity that our college presents to you. In the first Iron Man movie, as he's testing the flight capabilities of his new armor for the first time, Tony Stark tells his AI assistant, Jarvis, quote, "Sometimes you have to run before you can walk." College, much like the life that follows, is about situations that will require you to step outside of your comfort zone. You need to try despite any fear. Experiencing college comfortably may be safe, but leaping out and exploring new opportunities will make it much more rewarding. Exit your comfort zone. Do not miss the opportunities that UC presents to you. Third, be true to the work ethic and values that have gotten you this far in life, especially as a student, and never give up. In the film Captain America: First Avenger, scientist Dr. Erskine, as he's preparing Steve Rogers to undergo the treatment that will make him Captain America, reminds him, quote, "You will stay who you are, not a perfect soldier, but a good person." True character comes from within you. Success in college is not always attributable to being the smartest student for whom courses sometimes appear to come easily. Rather, the smartest students are the ones who never give up. Having high integrity will help to boost your morale, especially when you may feel low or feel just a little bit burned out. Self-motivation truly comes from within, and it does create success at college. Fourth, it's okay if your plans change. Part of the UC experience is to explore and to change as well. At the end of Spider-Man Homecoming, Peter Parker decides against becoming an Avenger. Quote, "I'd rather just stay on the ground for a little while. Somebody's got to look out for the little guy, right?" It is this growth that makes us human. Changing your goals sometimes can be seen as a good thing because it shows your adaptability to the world around you. Perhaps someday you may decide to explore other majors because you find you love this instead of that. Finding your passion and making yourself happy is part of what college is all about. Changing your goals or changing other aspects of your life may be part of that process. And finally, fifth, you are now part of the Utica College family, and it is a great family. It's also a diverse family, and we are truly greater than the sum of our parts. Two Marvel film quotes come to mind as I say that. First, from the original Avengers, Colonel Nick Fury motivates our heroes when they are at their lowest. When he said, quote, "There was an idea to bring together a group of remarkable people to see if they could become something more." And perhaps more important, from the Black Panther, when he tells the world through his speech at the United Nations, "We all know the truth. More connects us than separates us. We must find a way to look after one another as if we are one singular family." Reaching out to others for help is not a sign of weakness, it is a sign of strength. Whether that be your professors, whether that be your classmates, student services, academic support, we are together a group of remarkable people who can help you to become someone more than you are. Our diversity is also our strength. We come from all types of diverse backgrounds, and yet more still connects us than separates us. So experience the diversity, embrace the diversity, learn from it. You will actually soon learn more about an amazing opportunity to meet Dr. Sean Harper, who will join us on campus in September to talk more about the strength we gain from our differences. Watch for it. Now, this is now for all of you who watch Marvel movies, where a superhero movie typically rolls the end credits, maybe some fantastic closing music. But those of you who really watched all these movies realize that all but one of those films shows a post-credit scene or the teaser that prepares you for the next chapter. So here's the closing teaser that I intend to prepare you for your next chapter here at Utica College. At the end of the ceremony, as you leave through the doors that you came in, I want you to start your Utica College career remembering the words of Reed Richards, another one of my favorites, Mr. Fantastic from the Marvel Universe Fantastic Four, when he said, quote, "The door is more than it appears. It separates who you are from who you will become. And you don't have to walk through it, you can run." So I encourage you to run into your future at UC. Right? Utica College students, assemble. Okay. And welcome to Utica College. Thank you very much. We are now very privileged to have a proud Utica College alumnus give this year's convocation address. While earning his Bachelor of Arts in Sociology and Anthropology, he was a member of the Student Senate, which we now refer to as the Student Government Association, the Alpha Phi Alpha fraternity, and also a member of, and later elected president of, the Black Student Union. By his senior year, he became a visible and well-known student leader on our campus. Soon after completing his UC degree, he earned his Master's in Education Counseling from Bridgewater State University. A firm believer in lifelong learning, he has also received a number of certificates of advanced study in education, policy, leadership, and administration. More recently, he earned his Doctorate of Education degree in Higher Education Leadership and Management from Johnson & Wales University. Our speaker possesses expertise in education, personal and professional development, nonprofit organizations, business development, startups, and entrepreneurship. He holds experiences and skills in operations management, leadership, organizational behavior, diversity and inclusion, organizational culture, program evaluation, conflict resolution and employer relations, advising, and talent development. With more than 25 years of experience at the University of Massachusetts Dartmouth, his most recent role has been with their Charlton College of Business as Director of Corporate Development. He's a recent retiree, which I find hard to believe at such a young age. And you'll cringe when I announce it. And the reason why is because once you hear from him, you'll realize he will not be putting up his feet anytime soon. As an entrepreneur, his main focus will be principal consultant and manager of I Am Epic Enterprises, an educational, personal, and professional coaching enterprise. He first came to UC from the Bronx, and he now comes to us from New Bedford, Massachusetts. Please join me in welcoming home a pioneer from the class of 91, Dr. Anthony Baird.
I'm experiencing wardrobe malfunction, so let me fix my microphone. And I believe, Joe, you're going to switch me over to the headset, right? Okay. Bear with me. Okay. I promise it's going to be good. Sometimes in life you can't always rush. Good morning, beautiful people. Thank you, Provost Fenestill, for your welcome introduction. Board of Trustees Chair Bob Brennick. President Laura Casamento. Senior Vice President Jeff Gates, Student Government President Michael D'Elia, dedicated faculty and staff, and most important, the incoming class of 2019. Welcome to the convocation ceremony for the academic year 2019-2020. It is an honor and a privilege to have this opportunity to share my reflections of my journey and experiences at Utica College, and to offer some words of inspiration and motivation to the incoming class. However, before I proceed with my remarks, I want you to use this moment to capture the magic. And although Provost Fenestill said to turn off your phones and put it away, I want to ask you to take your phones out. This is a magical moment for you, so please go ahead and do that. I want you to take a picture, snap it, tag it, and post it, and then follow me. I'm making myself available to you as your quintessential motivational coach. At any point in time you have a question regarding your educational, personal, professional development, you can DM me at I am Epic, two P's, or Dr. Period Epic. This is the beginning of your new beginning, the foundation of your success. The theme for today's remarks is the constructing success, the business enterprise of you. From education to passion, from convocation to graduation, opportunities within your circumstances. Pay attention and be open to the opportunities within your circumstance. They serve as a foundation to your success. I came to Utica College a few days after graduating from high school, some 32 years ago. I want you to know, getting to college back then was riddled with similar challenges you have today. It was not less hard to afford tuition, fees, room and board, books, etc. Paying for application to multiple colleges and universities of my interest was not an option. I couldn't afford it. There was no common app back then. When you're a first-generation college student with his siblings ahead of you already in college, your turn to enter as a freshman comes down to which schools made access affordable for an 18-year-old Guyanese boy from the Bronx and to a single mother of five children. Some of my school choices were St. John's University. I got a scholarship to play the tuba. Hampton University, SUNY Binghamton, SUNY Albany, and Utica College of Syracuse University, as it was named. By a process of elimination, application fee waivers and size of financial aid packages were a major determining factor for whether I would come to college or not. The fine print in the Utica College brochure about HEOP, Higher Education Opportunity Program, caught my attention. It was for families with certain income levels and students with a demonstrated B or better GPA and some SAT score level. HEOP made college education possible for residents who were economically disadvantaged. I checked all those boxes. Although my circumstances seemed grim, it was Utica College's Summer Institute and the HEOP, led by Ms. Adelaide Lee, mentorship and friendship by Ms. Stacy Moore. Those were the opportunities in my circumstances that set the foundation for the educational, personal, and professional life I'm experiencing today. There's an old Chinese proverb that says, a journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step. On or around June 27th, 1987, I vaulted into my sister's boyfriend's blue pickup truck, it was blue, and journeyed the 252 miles, approximately 4 hours and 15 minutes, to Utica College. I was excited, anxious, overwhelmed to find out what the next chapter had in store for me. I landed here in the summer of 87 for a six-week program. As we pulled into the campus, the landscape was pristine. It was immaculate, a beautiful layout of architecture and landscape for a college campus. Coming from the Bronx and the city of New York as a whole, I thought I was Julie Andrews in The Sound of Music, frolicking about singing my favorite things. Well, that summer, I met some great people who became good friends, supportive faculty like Dr. Jan Diamichis, Dr. Scott Smith, Dr. Harold Piper, late Dr. Harold Piper, and a flexible and open-minded administration consisting of people like Dean Woods, Claudia Bell, Mark Kovacs, my brother from another mother, Richard Frank and Kay Habaika, and Connie Brown in financial aid. These people were my support network, my ecosystem that helped to facilitate my transformation here at Utica College. Utica College Summer Institute was the best thing that could have happened to a person of my predicament and circumstances. My circumstances did not define me. They informed my thinking, my determination, and my decision to never take any opportunity I was presented with for granted. The opportunity allowed me to explore the possibilities of what I might become in the future. I discovered my why, my purpose, my passion, my personal agency while I lived learned, and mature here. A few years into my journey, the president of the BSU, Ms. Brenda Godwin, approached me and said the three simple words that changed the trajectory of my educational, personal, and professional landscape. Brenda said, "You should run." I said, "What?" I replied. She said, "It's easy. All you have to do is write a few words about why you should be the president." I acquiesced. I took the gentle nudge from Brenda as a personal challenge and a plea from Brenda for someone to step up and lead the organization and execute its mission. It was evident that Brenda saw something in me that I had not realized about myself. I went home that end of the spring semester to write my first speech about a bus. BUS was an acronym for Black United Students who were led by bus driver, me, responsible for the goals surrounding the well-being, the education, the cultural heritage of Black students on a predominantly white college campus. We worked collaboratively with President Simpson, along with the Cultural Diversity Committee, when racism threatened our campus. More importantly, we established some notable tradition activities here on this campus. For example, the first candlelight visual march, the BSU Multicultural Center, the Big Chill Black Alumni Weekend, and the resurrection of the Alpha Phi Alpha Fraternity Incorporated. By the time I graduated from Utica College, I was working full-time at Mohawk Valley Community College. I was assistant director of activities and housing. I had changed my major and now became an anthropologist and a sociologist, and I made the dean's list. So the words of advice I would give to you are as follows. And what I want you to take away from my journey of reflection is that from the time I made the decision to experience Utica College, it was the moment I decided to begin the construction of my success. I had gotten the opportunity to attend Utica College. I had gotten the opportunity to lead at Utica College. And now I have the opportunity to represent Utica College, my alma mater, anywhere and everywhere I am in the world. Remember this. Pay attention and be open to the opportunities within your circumstances. They serve as a foundation to your educational, personal, and professional development. You are the architect of your success. Your success is not always on the construction. You succeed is to measure not by where you have been, but rather by the challenges and the obstacles you have hurdled while journeying to succeed. For today's workforce and the global economy, it is important that you see yourself as a business enterprise unto yourself, with a vision statement, a mission and a purpose statement, and a strategic execution plan. An entity that can negotiate and leverage your impact, your value, and your engagement to the world. Your personal brand requires a marketing and a promotional plan. You must prepare and be ready to bring your hashtags, your talent, your abilities, your gifts, and your skills to bear on the problems the world has yet to see. Innovation and creativity must be tools in your portfolio. So the business enterprise of you requires that you follow my eight principles. One, know thyself. Know your strengths and your weaknesses and the opportunities to your threats. It was Aristotle who said, "Know thyself is the beginning of wisdom." Think positively about your situation and yourself and the problems that you're facing. Norman Vincent Peale says the power of positive thinking. Three, according to Napoleon Hill in the book, Think and Grow Rich, anything you visualize, conceive, believe fervently, and then take measured steps towards its achievement, the reality is the manifestation of your creative visualization. In June of 2019, I was at a conference. I imagined myself speaking before an audience of your caliber. Today, here I am. Set goals and grow on all levels. You will go through situations that will cause you to transform, grow, change. Embrace it all. Five, remember, pressure brings diamond. A diamond is nothing but a chunk of coal that is made good on the pressure. When your heart is hit, it's not time to quit. Just do it like Nike says it. Six, you will get a strong sense of who you're to become and what you will do in the future based on the types of activities you are drawn to and you're thrusted into while you're here at Utica College. Seven, connect engage, and build meaningful relationships with the people around you and in your community. 8, mind your thoughts. Our thoughts become things. Rene Descartes says, I think, therefore I am. So in conclusion, in the words of Henry David Thoreau, I say go confidently and boldly in the directions of your dreams. Be great and live the life you have imagined. I want you to look to the person next to you, to the left and to the right, and repeat these words. I'm going to complete this degree with or without you. For those of you who are still hesitant and might be fearful, I leave you with this poem that is near and dear to me when I was trudging through the hills of Utica College. Invictus, by William Ernest Henley. Out of the night that covers me, black as a pit from pole to pole, I thank whatever gods may be for my unconquerable soul. In the fell clutches of circumstances, I have not winced nor cried aloud. Under the bludgeoning of chance, my head is bloody but unbowed. Beyond this place of wrath and tears looms but the horrors of the shade, and yet the menace of the years shall find and find me unafraid. I am the master of my faith. I'm the captain of my soul. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Baird, for those wonderful remarks. It is now my great pleasure to introduce Dr. Jeffrey Gates, Senior Vice President for Student Life and Enrollment Management, who will present this year's entering class. Dr. Gates.
Thank you. It is my pleasure to present and to turn over this incoming class to the provost, the faculty, and the student affairs staff. The entire campus community will be honored and here to support you on your journey of creating a future that's beyond your imagining. But before I do that, I need to share what the admissions staff learned about each and every one of you as your applications were read and decisioned. All of you bring many unique and inspiring talents to Utica College. Our higher learning community and institution is more enriched, and our community will be more connected through the personal stories and experiences that each of you shared with us and that you bring to our campus. The entering class that's in the room is full of achievers. It is my pleasure to introduce this class to all in attendance this morning. You are certainly a smart group, earning top achievements in many different academic areas. Three of you are either the valedictorian or salutatorian of your high school class, 36 of you are in the top 10, and 45 more are in the top 45, and 30% of you are in the top 25% of your high school class. 50 of you are in the Utica College Honors Program, and you come to Utica College from 22 different states, including California, Connecticut, Illinois, Florida, Maryland, Rhode Island, Minnesota, Michigan, North Carolina, New Jersey, Pennsylvania, New Hampshire, Vermont, Wisconsin, Maine, and Massachusetts, and from all across the globe, including Sweden, Saudi Arabia, and Vietnam. Isn't that awesome? That is really great. Utica isn't new for many of you. In fact, 8 of you have mom or dads who are working on campus, and many of you also follow UC legacy. Many of you have had parents, grandparents, siblings, and cousins who attended Utica College before you, so it's great to see the legacy continue with your college start. You are not seeing double. There are two sets of twins in the audience today. Others are a twin, and this is your first experience on your own. And one of you is on your own as a quintuplet here at Utica College. 38% of you have a desire to pursue athletics while attending Utica College. In fact, 90% of you told us that you participated in some form of athletic activity in high school. So whether you play on a team here or not, we know that you will be supporting your fellow classmates on and off the field. You also bring a breadth of experiences, personal reflections, and wishes with you. You wrote to us about your involvement in sporting events, various roles in plays, and your work outside of high school, in your participation with community service with the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. One of you has volunteered hundreds of hours through a biannual trip to Haiti to assist families still reeling from the devastation there. We learned about Teens in Action, among other youth leadership and nonprofit groups, through your stories. You have persevered through difficult experiences and felt the heavy weight of grief. You wrote about things you loved, like losing track of time while listening to your favorite music. Many of you have had rewarding experiences at national and state leadership academies and bring your leadership skills to Utica College. One of you even spent time on the U.S. National Olympic Luge development team. There are also a few hackers in the room. In fact, one of you hacked into your school system twice, explained how you did it, and begged to apply to UC before you even graduated. I'm sure all the hackers that are here will be participating in our hackathon that's held annually here on campus in the spring. You all have ambitions of personal growth and expectations and inspiring career goals that include being an OBGYN, a surgeon, a coach, an accountant, nurse, lawyer, an entrepreneur, a physicist, wellness expert, and the list goes on and on. Your unique experiences and varied preparation for this college experience, differing dreams and aspirations for careers, makes for a vibrant and dynamic community. We welcome you to Utica College and are looking forward to seeing your talent shine in and out of the classroom. Provost, I now present to you and the faculty this incoming class of stellar students who are ready to achieve personal and academic success. It is now my great pleasure to introduce our president, Dr. Laura Casamento.
I now ask the entering class of 2019 to please stand. It is my great pleasure to formally welcome you, our new freshmen, transfer, and graduate students to the Utica College community. I want to give a special welcome to our international students. You make significant contributions to the diversity that characterizes the Utica College community. I hereby invest you as newly admitted students with all of the rights and privileges that come with that accomplishment. Please join me in welcoming the entering class of 2019. You may be seated. I hope that by now you've begun to acclimate yourself to the wonderfully diverse Utica College community. You've doubtless met countless new people, some of whom will become your lifelong friends. You've begun familiarizing yourself with the campus, and that means checking out where to buy books, your first priority, and where to find food, although you might think that's your first priority. If you're living on campus, you've discovered that more than one bed can really fit in a room, but probably more than one 60-inch TV cannot fit. That's pushing it. Most importantly, you've had a chance to meet with all the people who will play a critical role during your career as a Utica College student, your professors. Please get to know them. They are absolutely essential to your academic success. Utica College's professors are internationally respected for their scholarly achievements, but what truly sets them apart is their personal commitment to you, the students they teach. Staff members throughout the college are equally committed, whether they are in student affairs, the Center for Career and Professional Development, food service, the Wellness Center, athletics, and yes, even the Office of the President. We are a caring community that cares very much for our students. We ask that you, in return, do this. Take your experiences at Utica College seriously. Go to your classes, be on time and prepared. Participate actively in class discussions. Study hard for your exams and reach out to your professors and success coaches if you find yourself needing help. This is a partnership, and we have a common goal to help you complete your college studies, prepared to take your place in the world. UC students, this convocation ceremony signifies your rite of passage into the Utica College academic community. It is also our invitation to learn all about our campus, as well as the local community we serve. Take advantage of the many opportunities you will have to participate in clubs, organizations, athletic activities, and contribute your time and talent in the service of others. Take, for example, Michael D'Elia, president of UC Student Government Association. Michael is a senior from Pequog, New York, majoring in construction management. He has been an active member in the Student Contractors Association and currently serves as president. In the fall of 2017, Michael joined several other students in traveling to Houston, Texas to assist in relief efforts after Hurricane Harvey. He has also served as a resident assistant and as an ambassador for the Office of Admissions. If you're looking for examples of getting involved, Michael can be your role model. As we conclude this convocation ceremony, I hope you will join in singing UC's alma mater. You'll find the lyrics in your program. In the meantime, I wish you great success, personal fulfillment, good health, and happiness as you undertake this new journey we call a Utica College education. Welcome to Utica College.
As we prepare to conclude this ceremony, a few brief instructions to our students. After the platform party and faculty recess, will the first year students please remain seated in the gym for the class photograph, which will be taken immediately following convocation. Guests are then asked to exit the gym through the doors in the rear. Will everyone please rise for the singing of our alma mater, which will be again sung by Nicole Collette, and then remain standing until the platform party and faculty recess from the auditorium. Nicole?
Our Utica proclaimed at birth that she was here to stay. Her graduates in Mohawk's Vale now everywhere hold sway. While loyal students spread our fame both far and near, we sing. Our power lies in daily search for truth to which we cling. Through college days, our stirring days, for learning's fruit we sigh. Commencement's thrill shines bright until the seniors say goodbye. But wisdom crowned, they venture forth, still young in heart they'll sing. Our power lies in daily search for truth to which we cling. Thank you.
Class of 2023, what's up?